We have a new twist on perhaps Mythbusters' most favorite and famous explosion.
That would be the cement truck.
Yes, it would. And it stars our favorite fictional honorary Mythbuster, Angus MacGyver. Let me set you the scene.
Come on, let's go, go!
A mail truck has been fitted with a bomb full of dynamite.
Keep it coming!
MacGyver brings a cement truck over to the mail truck and starts filling it with wet concrete. When he gets it above the bomb goes off. The cement seems to prevent the bomb from causing any real damage.
It worked.
I honestly don't know what would actually happen.
Which makes it a perfect myth for us to test. Our plan today is pretty straightforward. We're going to be detonating two mail trucks. Why two mail trucks? Well, one obviously will be full of wet cement, but their first blast will be empty.
Yes! The Mythbusters Postal Service. The skeletal bird with dynamite in his talons.
Why are we detonating an empty mail truck? Well, that's because we can't know if MacGyver's actions had any effect on the blast unless we have something to compare it to. That's our control.
For set dressing, the cop car that MacGyver hides behind is dropped into place. But the key to this myth is the mail truck's explosive cargo.
By looking at the clip, we've determined that they used about 84 pounds of dynamite. Now, this right here may look a little bit more festive, but this is actually what 84 pounds of dynamite looks like.
To quantify and compare the damage between the control and the concrete blasts, they'll measure two parameters. First, the shrapnel.
We want to know how dangerous the shrapnel might be, so we are implementing shrapnel catchers. We have cut out a ton of plywood dudes that we are going to place on a 30-foot radius between us and the blast so that we can see if chunks of metal fly off. Will it kill someone standing that far away? Let's mullet it up!
You know, while it's universally agreed that MacGyver brought ingenuity and cool problem solving to network television, it's not often discussed what he's done for the mullet.
Business in the front, party in the rear.
The second parameter is the pressure wave.
We'll be gathering precise data on the strength of our blast using one of these. This is a pressure transducer. Our blast obviously will put out a tremendous amount of energy, most of it in the form of a blast pressure wave. That wave will meet our pressure transducer. It'll exert a little mechanical energy on a tiny crystal inside the transducer called a piezo. When we hook it up to a computer, it gives us exactly how strong the blast pressure wave was where that pressure transducer was placed. Having all three of these data points for both blasts ought to give us a really good picture to see if MacGyver's cement made a difference between the control and the cement blast.
Mr. Hyneman, you ready?
Okay, arming and ready.
This is MacGyver, control, empty postal van, 84 pounds of TNT, in 3, 2, 1. That, I think there's still some stuff flying through the air.
Yeah, nobody go outside yet.
Nope.
What goes up comes down.
Yep, you've got hail. A hail of metal shrapnel.
Oh, look, the eagle has landed.
And plywood shrapnel catchers.
That's gotta hurt.
It's pure carnage for our shrapnel catchers. Legs and hands and mullets everywhere.
The blast was significantly more powerful than expected. At 30 feet, the shrapnel damage was clearly catastrophic. But what about the pressure sensors?
Oh.
Whoops.
It looks like all three of the sensors we had out here are totally busted.
With the cables for the pressure transducers shredded, even at 250 feet, they have no control data. And the next step will take some figuring out.
Well, we like to say failure is always an option, and it has to be, because we had a total failure of our pressure transducer system.
Whoops.
Oh. But we do have a plan B.
Yep, we're gonna focus on the physical evidence. Our cutouts tell us the shrapnel was catastrophic at 30 feet. But we can also compare the strength of the control to the concrete-covered blast by measuring how far the shrapnel flew.
That's a heavy thing, and it shot it about 150 feet.
First, we mark out the more sizable pieces on foot.
That's got to be one of the farthest chunks.
And then we get the big picture by air.
This right here is the newest piece of amazing camera equipment that Mythbusters has brought to bear on shooting our episodes over the past couple of years. This is called a DJI Inspire 1. And we use the Inspire to witness our entire debris field in one shot.
Yep, from this bird's eye view, the debris field can be mapped at a maximum radius of 675 feet. Cue truck number two.
This is our 84 pounds of dynamite. And the reason I'm locking all this stuff down is that this stuff is lighter than concrete and it might float. Now wait, these detonation cords and things like that won't come out, hopefully.
Similar to the shelves in the original clip, Jamie's placed one bundle of dynamite down low and one up top. And screwing them to the wooden frame should prevent them from floating free when the concrete flows. Meaning it's time for man of the moment.
How you doing?
MacGyver.
I like the sling. Maybe I'm gonna try it out.
Our mulleted hero springs into action.
And perfect, right there.
Matching the clip, he directs the dump truck to unload 8 cubic yards or 32,000 pounds of wet cement.
It's coming out. It looks kind of like a cow taking a dump.
It really does look like a cow taking a dump, and I've never even seen that.
Wow.
It'll take 30 minutes to fill her up, but there's a problem.
Fill it.
What's up?
Look at the bag of explosives that came out from under the table.
Oh,
despite Jamie's precautions,
what do we do? What can we do?
40-odd pounds of primed-to-explode dynamite is dangerously detached. It has to be secured and fast.
We can cut a bigger hole and crawl through this.
Ironically, they've got to MacGyver the situation. With the cement already 12 inches deep, they can't go through the doors.
I'm sorry, but I have to take off the MacGyver wig.
The cement is rapidly setting. The sun is heating the truck interior to a stifling 150 degrees.
Ah,
and there's an unexploded bomb to be manhandled.
Whew. All right, I'm in. Oh, that feels
all in a dangerous day's work for the Mythbusters.
Okay. Right, I just remembered this is 40 some odd pounds of TNT. Gonna handle it gently. All right.
To make sure they match the clip,
thank you.
The loose bag has to be submerged under the concrete. So Adam boxes it in and with some 2x4, screws it down.
Yeah, you aren't going anywhere.
Before escaping with a brand new pair of concrete boots.
Yes! Oh! Yes! Ah!
Nice work, Houdini.
Thank you.
How to escape upside down out of a container full of concrete and explosives.
And with that,
let's clear the area. Let's start pumping.
MacGyver's back on track to save the day. Or is he?
This is a new problem. Like, we needed more. It might be pushing out the sides of our truck and leaking out. 32,000 pounds. That's 16 tons. My guess is that's more than this truck was built to take. Wow, that is a lot of pressure on those doors. It's a lot of mail.
In the clip, the truck wasn't affected by the extra weight, but in real life, it's only just holding together.
Let's kill it.
The team has to move fast before it fails.
So where we are right now is that we have just covered the bomb with concrete, and we are working very hard to, as the bomb techs would say, de-ass the area. Trying to get all the equipment out, then we'll get all the people back to the bunker, then we're gonna blow this puppy.
3, 2, 1.